Hello everybody, I am Chitanshu from Dream Abroad, and in this video we would discuss the very important question that should you actually accept the PNP invitations or not? Accept it? You would say that we are dying to get those PNP invitations, so why we are even talking about this question that should we accept it or refuse it? So I'm talking in respect to the OINP tech draws which was actually issued last week. Actually, six of my friends or maybe friends of friends called me and talked to me about it. They actually got the invitations. I actually also belong to the tech industry, so obviously my friend circle is also in this tech industry. So six of them have actually called me since last week to ask if they should actually accept it or not. Okay, let me give you a background of it first of all. So on January 7th or 8th, the first express entry draw of this year was conducted when the CRS cutoff score was 473. Then on January 15th, I think the first OINP tech draw was conducted for this year. And that was for those people whose CRS score was from 462 to 473. So their question was actually genuine because they were concerned that should they actually wait for the CRS cutoffs to drop until they get the ITA. So the CRS cutoff was 473 in the first draw of 2020. They were waiting that it could drop like 6-7 points and they might get the invitations. What I suggested to them and why I thought of making this video for you guys, because I thought that many people would be sailing in the same boat. So why not discuss this with you in this video? So what I suggested them is that they should accept those invitations. Now, why I suggested them this was for a specific reason, because basically all of my all of those people who actually called me had the CRS score of 463, 465, 464, 6, something like that. So obviously I looked at the trends. The CRS cutoff score has actually been revolving around 470 in the last couple of months, and there are chances that it will come down, but not in the upcoming draws, not at least in the upcoming 2-3 months. So I suggested them that it's a big risk that they'll take if they actually refuse that OINP invitation. Now definitely it is when I say risk, it obviously means that there are chances that the cutoff score might drop and they might curse themselves or curse me after that I suggested them this. But yes, if it does not drop, then they would curse themselves for not accepting that invitation. Now, the OINP invitation actually costs you a lot of money. I think it's around $1,500 that you have to pay for that invitation. Like if you accept that invitation and if you agree to process your application through OINP. And obviously there would be a time gap between for a couple of months until they process your applications. So all of these were the concerns that, why should we actually waste $1,500? And some of them were like, why should we actually wait? Why should we actually go for OINP? We might get the invitation. Now, actually, one of them had the CRS score of 469 and he created his profile just a few days ago. So I suggested him to wait for some time because it's definitely it would drop to 469. And in the last draw, it dropped two more points. Maybe in the next draw, it would drop a couple more points. So it was definitely worthy if you are in that range of 469, 470 ones. So let's assume that someone who had the score of 472 or 471 and he goes for OINP, but in the next draw, he would get that invitation because the cutoff score actually dropped to 471. So what I suggested them was that they should wait for around 35 to 40 days. In that time span, a couple of more draws would be conducted and they would understand the trends, if it's actually going down, if it's actually going up. And in the meanwhile, they can actually prepare their documents. If they feel that, everything, that the CRS cutoff score is actually going up, they should actually go on to apply for OINP. But if they feel that maybe they're sitting at 467 and the CRS score is 468, maybe in the next draw, they would definitely get the invitation. So in that case, they should definitely hold on the OINP application and and hopefully they would get the ITA through the federal system. Apart from ONP tech draws, we have also seen the similar pattern for other ONP streams like HCP stream, which is the most famous stream. So I would suggest all of those people who actually get those invitations not to decline those invitations immediately. Wait for maybe a month or so, because you've got time for 1.5 months to submit your application. If you've got that invitation, it actually means a world to a lot of people. It actually means a lot that you've got that invitation, and that is because of your CRS score that you've got that invitation. So obviously you should respect that. And anyways, most of the people, I don't say all, but yes, most of the people would actually come to Toronto. And that's what the statistics say, that most of them do actually come to Ontario. Ontario is the hub of immigrants. So anyways, if you had to come to Toronto and maybe Ottawa, these kind of places, so it's really good that you've got that invitation. You should actually consider accepting that. And I'm actually giving you this advice based on a couple of the experiences that a few people have actually shared with me. They were actually waiting for CRS cutoff to drop, and they declined the OINP, and the CRS cutoff score actually never dropped till their points. Instead, their CRS score dropped because of their age, and obviously there was no scope whatsoever for them to get the federal invitation without the PNP. And they were then cursing themselves that why did they actually decline that OINP invitation. It's very precious. So guys, I really hope that the message that I wanted to convey to you guys through this video, that you should definitely consider accepting that those OINP or Ontario invitations, even if your CRS score is very close to the cutoff score, because you never know that the CRS score will actually go up in the upcoming time, it will go down. So you should never decline it right away. Do your analysis and think about it, then only go on to decline it, or maybe not submit that invitation. So thank you guys, that was all the information that I wanted to share through this video, or maybe an advice that I wanted to share with all of you guys through this video. Keep supporting me, keep loving me, please share your comments down below, what do you feel about it. And obviously, if you haven't subscribed my channel yet, what are you waiting for? Please click the subscribe button before moving on to the next video.